Hi, this is Andy from Govprep. Today we're going to talk a little bit about how the government spends and how to work with the government if you are kind of nervous about getting into the business. So first things first, the federal government spends trillions of dollars every year on contracting, acquisitions, procurement, all basically means the same thing. A nice thing, since it's the federal government, there are certain rules that play very much into your benefit. So contracting officers are really the only people that are authorized to sign the checks. By law, those contracting officers in the federal government doing business with that trillions and trillions of dollars, they have to do a certain percentage of their work with small businesses. So what that means to you is a huge opportunity for you to actually use that to your advantage. 23.7% of the federal budget has to be spent on small businesses. There are some specific definitions of what a small business is, but suffice to say, if you are not operating, tens of millions of dollars in revenue and you're not hundreds and hundreds of employees, probably you're a small business. Especially if you fall into one of these four special categories. So, minority-owned company. That's a company that is owned by 51% or more of a minority. Is that Latino American? Is that African American? Is that Asian American? Several categories, but all minority owned. The next category is woman owned. 51% of the business has to be owned and operated by a female. That can be multiple women, that can be a single woman, but 51% of the company has to be owned by females. Next category is 3% for veteran-owned companies. Same thing. The company, your company, has to be owned by at least 51% of veterans. The last category is historically underutilized business zone. That's called hub zone. So there are some specific rules with this one, but basically the business has to be based, principal office in a hub zone, in a historically underutilized business zone, and then 35% or more of the employees have to work within, they have to reside or domicile within, they have to live inside a hub zone. So this can get kind of complicated. There's applications and processes to this. At GovPrep, that's one of the things that we help out with. Going through that certification process, absolutely critical to being successful in the small, not required, but absolutely success, a leg up, a benefit to doing business with the federal contracting officers. They have to spend, the government has to operate. In order for the government to operate, they need contractors to do jobs, whether that's buying pencils or paper clips or building aircraft carriers, lawn maintenance, hundreds and hundreds, actually 1,300 different categories of work. All of those things have to be contracted out. That contract is required by a contracting officer. That contracting officer must spend 23% of their budget, 23.7% of their budget every year with small businesses, 5% of their total budget with minority-owned companies, 5% with woman-owned, 3% with veteran-owned, 3% with hub zone-owned. If you are multiple of the, if you're an African American woman, who was in the military, great. You satisfy three of those categories for the contracting officer. Again, you do not have to be certified to do business with the federal government, but it definitely gives you a leg up. It definitely is an advantage to you when you're talking and you're discussing with those contracting officers. Again, GovPrep, GovPrep.com. We're here to help through those through that application process. Definitely something you can do on your own, but just like your taxes, it's something that we can help out with. So give us a call. We're here to help, and good luck to you.